everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a LEGO Legends of Chima set review. This is a two Speedor set, Speedors sets as they call them. This is the Ultimate Speedor Tournament with 246 pieces. It costs $30. It's set number 70115. Not one of the most recent ones, but I wanted to go over it anyway. So let's go ahead and get some of the kind of mundane stuff out of the way quickly. Couple of ripcords for your two Speedors, one in yellow, it's the slightly orangish yellow, and one in normal green for your lion tribe and your croc tribe. We have 12 pieces of chi here, not six, 12, because it's a two Speedor set, so you've got twice as much on the line. Oh no, get back here. You get two sets of playing cards. Here is Laval's set, and there's not a whole lot that can be done with these, so I won't hold you up talking about them. Go ahead and hit the pause button if you want to look at these more carefully. And here we go with Krager's set of cards. So once again, hit pause if you want to see these, and I'm going to move on. For weapons, the two on the left are for Laval, and the two on the right are for Krager. This first one is called a Jahak, and it's basically a halberd. It is a long-handled axe with, in this case, a point on the end also. And then his chi-powered sword weapon is a Valius over here for Krager. He has a Gronk, which is basically a flail. If you haven't checked out flails, it's worth a good Google and check it out on Wikipedia and Google Images, an actual real weapon, F-L-A-I-L. And for his chi-powered weapon, it's the Vengeous. Well, it's a Vengeous, one of the common croc tribe weapons. Here are your minifigs for this set. Once again, Laval and Krager. And they are fully decorated in this set. They've got the full armor and the little chi crystal in the chest. And they also have their full capes on. So this is as good as they get. I'll let you see what the faces look like underneath. Not a whole lot of facial expression comes through once you put the outer headpiece on, but you still see you get slightly different eyes, which kind of show through the eye holes a little bit. Here's Laval on his Speedor. This is the slightly orangish yellow color. It's got a pretty nice print on the side of it. The front is a little bit basic, but this part back here, kind of the main detail behind the ear of the Speedor, looks pretty nice with a little webbing in there. It's got silver, so you can actually see the light really reflecting off of that, and the dark red inside of there. And for the power up, in this case, we get a couple of power saws basically on the side, and you can adjust the angles of those to make it go up higher if you want. Get kind of an interesting different look, but for the most part, you're gonna want to leave that down. I will tell you what's going on, or tell you what I don't know about what's going on with the power up in just a second after we look at Krager. So here's Krager on his Speedor, and this one looks very appropriate for the croc tribe. I mean, I love the shape of this thing, very, very close to the type of animal that it's approximating. It's in the olive green color, which is not so common, but it is used for the croc tribe. I think that works out really well. It's got the print along the side that fits in with their other sets and their other pieces, kind of the general look and feel that they've got for their artful style. You see the eye is different on each side, which relates to Krager himself very personally. And the power up here, this is called a tra-tra-tracks. Tra-tra-tracks. I'm serious, tra-tra-tracks. The whole idea with it is that it kind of leaves scorched earth behind it. It cuts a path around you as you go through the forest. But here's the odd thing about this, okay? In the cards, they show the tra-tra-tracks. See, you didn't believe me? Tra-tra-tracks. Yeah. They show it being equipped on Laval's Speedor. So what's up with that? It's not my mistake. I built this according to the instructions. The instructions have you put this power-up on Krager's Speedor. This power-up, on the other hand, we don't even have a card for it. We don't know what it's called because the power-up that's supposed to be on Krager's Speedor is called a Grapt. And you can see it uses an Exo-Force arm here, and then some sort of it's like a grappling hook kind of thing added on, I'm assuming there would be one on each side, you can pretty much see how that's supposed to be built, but we don't build it in this set. So a little bit of confusion went on there. These here do show you what is shown on the box art though. So this is less confusing though. This is the main obstacle of the set, the main thing that uses up the most parts, and it looks really, really, really good. Lego designers are just so good at pulling off these small part counts, animal looking builds, brick builds, you know, just looks so good. That lion head with the angle that they got on it and everything, it just fits together, and it's not just sitting there, it's actually locked together really well. So that's well done. It's intended to be a sculpture. It's not intended to look just like a lion. So it's a little bit abstract, but I think especially with those eyes, that's really well done. And then they just added on these claws just to kind of give you the feel a little bit more of as if they were legs down the side. You've got a target in the middle. The head does not move at all. You've got a target in the middle, and what happens when you hit that is that it can knock off this chi orb that's sitting back here. So this is one of those sets where you go through and you try to actually grab the orb. You know, you're gonna hit it with a Speedor, and then you have to kind of have a race. If you've got multiple people going at the same time or playing at the same time, then it's kind of a mad dash to see who grabs the orb first. So it's a pretty simple mechanism, but I think it works really well, nicely balanced. It has some weight there. You can't just barely tap it. You have to actually have some speed. You have to actually go through, and it's going to actually hit it up in the air, cause it to bounce a little bit, so it's not just kind of falling off. Good design there. I appreciate that. You know, they did use a lot of pieces to make this one mechanism. You know, they didn't need to have any of this. Most of this just could have been done much more simply, but I appreciate it. It looks good. They also give you this stuff. So it's a ramp with a little bit of foliage on it in bright green. Get a couple of pylons, and these are basically torches because they've got flame coming out of them. And then you have another kind of stand, another kind of tall pylon here with a chi orb on top of that. So the idea here with this whole set, I'm going to zoom this out and kind of line them up a little bit. You can put the pylons wherever you want. They can be used just for the appearance, just to look good, or you can actually set them up where they're intended to be a penalty, where if you hit one of those, then you miss the round, or maybe you're not allowed to grab both. You're only allowed to grab a maximum of one. You kind of have to set the rules there how you want, be a little bit imaginative with it. But this is intended to be chained together. So you run your Speedor through and you hit here. That's the idea, is to get through the first obstacle. Hit here, knock off that chi orb. You'll keep going through. You see, this has enough range of motion to go all the way up. This is, normally they would not be this close together, all the obstacles. Try to hit this. Ramp actually has little rubber bits on the bottom to try to keep it from moving too far, but it will still move. You try to go up and hit this. You try to hit this and actually knock it off. So this is actually two pieces here that can come out. It's not always going to happen. Oftentimes you're going to hit the whole thing and just knock the whole thing over, but that's going to release one more chi orb. So you have the possibility of hitting or knocking out a maximum of two chi orbs, and then you can choose whether you want to allow double-handed rules for this, where you can use both of your hands, or if you want to use single-handed rules, which is going to make it a little bit better for a two-person play, where you have to grab one of the chi orbs and then grab the other one with the same hand. So you might actually drop one, or the other player may go for the other orb at the same time. But this is definitely geared towards two-player play, but if you want to do it single player, you can still do that. Move this back farther. Well, you can either chain them together and you run one Speedor at a time and you count how many orbs are successfully knocked off by each, and whichever knocks off the most orbs is the winner for a given round. or you can do them individually and, you know, just do it like so. Run, put this far enough back where it's actually a challenge to hit the target. Run each Speedor independently until you get one of them having more hits than the other. Set it up as best of three, best of five, best of seven, however you want to do that. And then you can run this one separately. Or you can mix and match. Set these up, have a pylon knockdown, or have a pylon long jump. Try to get over, actually jump over these without hitting them, or try to hit just the last one. Lots of different things you can do. So you do really have to use your imagination with this, or you are encouraged to use your imagination with this. And I appreciate that also, because it just, you know, it opens up more possibilities for play with this thing. And that's really what it's all about. So the cost of this was, again, $30, which is the cost of two normal Speedors sets. And given that you get two normal Speedors and they're fully set up with the full costume and everything, you know, it's the highest level of figure design, and you do get at least two obstacles, you can set them up as more if you like, I think that the value works out well. And you do get the two kind of stars, you know, the main good guy and the main bad guy of the series, at least for season one. So it's, you know, it's definitely something that's highly desired, and the price per part is reasonable compared to others, and the playability is pretty good for the price. So I'm happy with this one. I think it worked out well. Of course, you get the cards too. A little bit of confusion with the power-ups or the boosts there, but again, you can use your imagination or put your own parts together and make your own custom ones. So that's it for my look at the Ultimate Speedor Tournament 70115 from LEGO Legends of Chima. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more at jangbrickss.com. And if you want to see other videos that I've done in the past, be sure to check those out on my channel. Please do hit the thumbs down button on the video if you don't like the video. Be sure not to watch videos that you don't like. Even if I post them and you are subscribed, you're not required to watch them all. Just watch stuff that you enjoy. But if you don't like a video after watching it, do hit thumbs down. Still helps me out, helps me to get more views, and I very much appreciate that. So I will talk to you again soon.